Okay, dear learners, let us discuss around four problems on indeterminate forms. So this is again really interesting problem. Limit x to the power y minus y to the power x upon x to the power x minus y to the power y as x tends to y. So can you tell me the form of this L equal to? Which is this form? X tends to y. X is a variable and y is a constant. So replace every x with y. Numerator will be y to the power y minus y to the power y. That is zero. Denominator will be y to the power y minus y to the power y. Zero. So this is 0/0 form. Okay. So we have to make use of L'Hospital's rule. So this is equal to limit. Tell me derivative of numerator with respect to x. Quickly, what is derivative of x to the power y with respect to x? Nobody? All the four varieties are covered here. AP6 had immediately told. Sanga patkan.
Sir, y x raised to y minus 1.
Y x raised to.
Very good. Y into x to the power y minus 1. Minus. What is derivative of y to the power x with respect to x?
X y to the power
x. X into y to the power x minus
1. X minus 1.
Wrong.
X log y.
Y.
X log y.
X into log y.
Till completely, that will be
y raised to x into log y.
Yes, very good.
X into log of y.
Divided by. Now tell me derivative of denominator. So the first derivative of x to the power x with respect to x.
X raised to x into the log x.
Into 1 plus log x. Okay. Minus derivative of y to the power y with respect to x.
Zero.
As x tends to y. So this is equal to limit y into y to the power y minus 1 minus y to the power y into log y upon y to the power y into 1 plus log of y. Okay. So I should not write their limit. I erase that part. And again, this is equal to y to the power y 1 minus log of y divided by y to the power y into 1 plus log y. And after simplification, the answer is 1 minus log y upon 1 plus log y. So please take screenshot. You can ask, you can see it is a very small problem, but really logical. I am moving for the next problem. So the problem is, if L limit sine 2x plus p into sin x upon x cube as x tends to 0 is a finite real number, then determine the value of p and hence the value of the limit also. We have solved one problem of this type yesterday. Now, let me write this once again. L equal to limit sine 2x plus p into sine x upon x cube as x tends to 0. Tell me the form. What is the form?
0 by 0.
Yes, 0 by 0 form is there. And we can continue. We can make use of L'Hospital's rule, right? But I will try to simplify this limit first and then evaluate further. So here, sine 2x is equal to 2 into sine x into cos x plus p into sine x upon x to the power 3. So this is limit here. In the numerator, sine x is common. So sine x is multiplied with 2 cos x plus p, and I am writing x below sine x and remaining part is x square. This is just adjustment as x tends to 0. We know limit sine x upon x, x tends to 0 is 1, and we are remaining with limit 2 into cos of x plus p upon x square as x tends to 0. Now let us put x equal to 0 and we are getting this numerator as 2 into cos 0 is 1 plus p upon 0. So 2 plus p upon 0, definitely there is guarantee that denominator is 0. There is little confusion about the numerator. 2 plus p, whether it is 0 or not 0, there are only two possibilities. So what? It must be 0.
0.
Because yesterday we have seen that if numerator is not 0, then non-zero quantity upon 0 will be infinity. And in this problem, we are given that the value of this limit is finite. So we must have, let me write, which is finite. So we must have two plus p equal to 0. That is p equal to minus 2. So this is the first part we have found out. Now let us try to put this value of p in the latest limit. So limit 2 into cos of x plus p means minus 2 upon x to the power 2 as x tends to 0. And we know that this is 0 by 0 form. Let us apply L'Hospital's rule. So this will be 2 into minus sine of x minus 0 upon 2 into x as x tends to 0. Again, 2 cancels, minus 1 can be taken outside the limit, treating it as a constant. Limit sine x upon x as x tends to 0, and the answer is equal to minus 1. And thus, we have completely solved the first part that was asked, value of p. So p is equal to minus 2. And also value of the limit L, L is equal to minus 1. So please take the screenshot. We move for next. This is another problem. evaluate limit log of tan of x upon log x as x tends to zero. So first tell me the form of this. Numerator will tend to log of tan of zero. We know tan of zero is zero. So my question to all of you, what is log of zero? Log of zero equal to?
Infinity.
Absolutely.
One.
Option. Infinity. B. One. Ajun Sanga. अजून कुठले ऑप्शन आहे?
झिरो.
झिरो. ओके. अजून
इन्फिनिटी.
इन्फिनिटी.
मायनस इन्फिनिटी.
मायनस इन्फिनिटी. अजून काय आहे का सांगा? सो मेनी ऑप्शन्स.
वन.
वन सर.
आय विल टेल. नो. डिफरंट पीपल आर giving different answers, so that should not happen. So there must be unity with respect to your opinion toward this problem. I will like to briefly explain you the meaning of logarithm. So see friends, log of some number, suppose some number, real number, log of r, real number, 2 base b is equal to, this is equal to, suppose, a. What is meaning of this? What to the power what equal to what? See, if you tell value of the logarithm, value of logarithm is equal to a here, and that is nothing but power of the base. Lakshya. It is value of logarithm is always power of the base. So b to the power a is equal to r. That is the meaning. So this way is presented in the form of logarithm. And tell me, and again, this base of logarithm is always greater than 1. Okay. So we know sometimes b is equal to e. Sometimes b is equal to 10. E has value 2.718283, so greater than 1. So, okay. Now tell me, what is log of 1 to any base? To any base. Log of 1?
0.
The reason is that this b to the power 0 is equal to 1. That's why 0 is the value. Now tell me, what is log of infinity to any base? So you can treat e, 10, anything in place of b. So what is log of infinity to any base? That means my question is, b to the power what is equal to infinity? So that box will be written here. Tell. Okay, b equal to 10. 10. 10 to the power what will be plus infinity?
Infinity.
Absolutely correct. Yes. Actually, see, in general, if there is some for any real number r, then r to the power infinity will be, it is taking different values. Baga, if r equal to 1, r equal to 1, then 1 to the power infinity, indeterminate form. Okay. For r equal to 1. Then when r is greater than 1, then r to the power infinity will be plus infinity. Then when r is greater than zero strictly and less than one strictly, then r to the power infinity will be zero. And when r is less than or equal to zero, it will be oscillatory. So do not go in so many details. The only thing is that b is always greater than one. So in this problem, b to the power infinity is equal to plus infinity. That's why logarithm of infinity to any base b is equal to infinity. And finally, tell me, what is log of zero to any base b? Tell me, what is the answer? Or you can tell me, b to the power what is equal to zero?
Not defined?
No, not correct. Please.
One.
Infinity.
Please unmute because there was a other additional voice also. So I muted some. B to the power one. B to the power one will be B. We want B to the power something equal to zero. What is that something?
Infinity.
No, B to the power infinity will be plus infinity. We have just seen. You can see at the above right corner.
Zero.
Minus infinity.
Minus infinity. B to the power minus infinity. See, B to the power minus infinity is equal to 1 upon B to the power infinity. I have already told B is greater than 1. So B to the power infinity will be plus infinity. And 1 upon infinity is 0. So B to the power minus infinity is equal to 0. That's why log of 0 to any base B is equal to minus infinity. And here the first problem, log of 0 to any base is equal to minus infinity. So I think it is very much clear to you. I have spent a few minutes, but that is really worth. So if you want, you can take screenshot within 2 seconds. I am going to erase. Okay, I am erasing now. Tell me the form. L equal to
infinity by infinity.
Oh, yes, exactly. Actually, it is minus infinity upon minus infinity. So we can say, yes, it is infinity upon infinity form. Therefore, we can make use of L-Hospital's rule, L equal to limit. Now, I am not going to make any discrimination. Derivative of, definitely, we are going to have the understanding. Derivative of numerator will be in numerator, derivative of denominator will be in denominator. Okay. So otherwise, okay, otherwise we'll do that. Okay. Now tell me, what is derivative of log of tan of x with respect to
sec square x upon tan x?
1 upon
tan x into sec square x.
Into
1 upon tan x into
sec square x. Okay.
Sec square x.
Now in denominator, there is log of x. What is derivative of log x with respect to x?
1 upon x.
As x tends to 0. So this is equal to limit. Let us simplify this. Sec square x means 1 upon cos square x. Then in denominator, there is cos x, so tan x. So that means in denominator, sin x upon cos x and into x. Is it fine? As x tends to 0. So this is equal to limit cos 0 is 1. So x upon sin x. As x tends to 0, and the answer is equal to. Fine. So take the screenshot. Let us move further. I think this will be the fourth problem. Limit cot x to the power sin x, x tends to 0. So you tell me the form. Cot 0. Cot 0?
Infinity.
Infinity. To the power sin 0?
Zero.
Zero.
So this is infinity to the power zero form. See carefully. I have told that among the seven, there are four forms in which there is exponentiation or power. In that, immediately we have to take logarithm. Therefore, log of L equal to limit. Tell me, limit of log of cot of x to the power sin x.
Sin x log of cot x.
Sin of x into log of cot of x as x tends to 0. Now, which is this form? Sin 0 is 0 into log of cot of 0. Cot 0 is infinity and log of infinity is infinity. So, initially we had infinity to the power 0 form. We have converted it into 0 into infinity form. Now, we have to make use of L'Hospital's rule. For the same, we want either 0 by 0 form or infinity upon infinity form. Which one, whatever is more comfortable to us. See the first option. First option, put sin of x in the numerator. And the remaining part is to be taken in denominator, and in denominator we will have 1 upon log of cot of x, and we will be having 0 upon 0 form. This is the first option with us. Now the second option with us is that keep log of cot of x in the numerator. And sin x should be taken in the denominator, that will be cosec of x. And we will be having infinity upon infinity form. So between these two, which one is easier? Tell me. Which one will be easier? Are you getting me or not?
Sin x numerator 1 upon cosec x.
Yes, yes. Because see, sin x and log cot x, between these two, log of cot of x is somewhat more difficult expression. So we'll try to keep it in numerator. Okay. So we'll be keeping log of cot of x in numerator and sin of x in denominator will become cosec of x as x tends to 0. And now we have infinity upon infinity form. Initially we had infinity to the power 0. later 0 into infinity, and now infinity upon infinity form. So this is equal to limit, let us apply L'Hospital's rule. Now I am going to have only one numerator, only one denominator. The only thing we have to understand that derivative of numerator must be in numerator and derivative of denominator must be in denominator. In numerator, there is log of cot of x. Tell me derivative of numerator with respect to x quickly. Come on.
Minus cos x by cot x.
I will first say 1 upon cot x into derivative of cot x, that is minus cos x square x. Fine. We have written derivative of numerator in numerator. Now we'll write derivative of denominator in denominator. In derivative, in denominator, there is cosec x. What is derivative of cosec x?
Minus cot x into cosec x.
That is minus cosec x into cot x. I am writing it in denominator. Okay. As x tends to 0. And let us just try to simplify this. So this will be limit. Minus minus cancels, remaining cosec square x is in numerator, that becomes as sine square x in denominator. In denominator there is cot x, that is nothing but tan x in numerator. Then again in denominator there is cosec x, that becomes sine x in numerator, and cot x in denominator becomes tan x in numerator. So this is equal to as x tends to 0. This is equal to limit. Tell me if there is any suggestion. Sin x is going to cancel. Okay. Sin x cancels. 1. But there is tan square x. So tan square x upon x square x. I am saying x square. Okay. Then only sin x is remaining in denominator. I am saying it 1x here. And additional x is here. See. Are you getting this? Very easy. समझते का sin x upon sin square x is sin x in denominator, so I am purposely dividing by x, and then tan square x I am dividing by x square, so I have written only x in numerator and x square in denominator, so I am writing one more additional x in numerator. So limit of tan square x upon x square as x tends to 0 will be 1. Then limit of sin x upon x will be 1. And the answer is equal to 0. Hey, samajla ka nahi samajla? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And samajla pan nasel. Nasel samajla ta kai harkat nahi. लिमिट x टेंड्स टू 0 काय करतो बघा मी आता tan x, tan x कसं लिहिता येईल आपल्याला sin x upon cos x, ठीक आहे. नंतर खाली sin square x आहे, नंतर वर एक अजून एक sin x आहे आणि अजून एक tan x, sin x upon tan x, सॉरी sin x upon cos of x, ठीक आहे. सो नो वरी, दिस sin x into sin x square cancels with sin square x, and cos 0 in the denominator is 1, and sin of 0 is 0. That's 1. Thus, finally, you can go by any logic. answer will be the same. Log of L is equal to 0. Therefore, we must have L equal to e to the power 0. And therefore, L must be equal to 1. So, most of the students are forgetting this step. They begin with log of L. They simplify log of L and keep 8 as a final answer. But that is not the correct. We must, yes, you can take screenshot and see. You have to take care to write correct value of L as we have simplified log of L. Okay. I think that we have discussed 4 problems today. 4 problems zale ka aaple aaj?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So it is time. So you must have taken screenshot. I stop sharing and I stop recording.